guy at Cabin Fever offered to sell me a 2 or 3 of them.
Yeah, right.
He wanted a lot of money.
Did he? Our friend Peter Renzetti. Good morning, Pete.
Good morning, Gil. How
nice
are
to
you?
See you. That's an amazing little engine you have here. This is a flat 6 high-speed steam engine, I believe. Got a nice sound to it, too.
If you put the pressure to it, it'll fly.
Oh, I bet it will.
But it enjoys me.
So many nuts and bolts. Somebody went to work.
Yep.
What a great find. Congratulations.
Now, I'd love to have seen the boat that they were trying to.
Oh, yeah.
But it came out of, it must have come out of a boat that there's a gap coupling here.
Wow.
That is so sweet.
Yeah, that is sweet. How long did you have to wait before you could acquire?
About 10 years.
About 10 years. Well, I'd say well worth the wait.
Ah, oh, yeah.
There's a neat, very old steam plant. Really nice one. And here's a motion feature wheel.
It's really neat. It has a slot in this gear.
Uh-huh.
With a pin off center on the crank and behind it.
Yeah.
And it's actually very similar to this one, only this one you can see.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Right.
Some of these teaching aids were great.
Circular collineal motion.
Uh-huh. Here's a, this looks like a gasoline engine. Yep, spark and everything. That's great.
I figured it'd be better with batteries so you could see the lights on.
Yeah. Oh, that's super. Thank you. And here's another ancient steam engine, a tandem compound. This is a very old model.
And there's a whole chart down here.
With a Walter.
Yep.
Right. That's what it said here. Do me a favor. Gently just hold that pointer toward this side of the ground. Here's a larger teaching aid model than you usually see.
Number one, the biggest one.
The big one, the number one. And here's a real interesting engine. What can you tell me about this?
This I picked up at Hershey Car Show Flea Market probably 25 years ago.
That's right.
And it came from an executive who had it on his desk for about 14 years. He bought it at a state auction, and that's as much as he knows, but the inside of this engine is awesome. It's a T-head, has an intake on one side, the exhaust on the other. And there's not too much I know about. It has a little fin that comes out of the flywheel for cranking.
Okay.
And it has a distributor up here.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what this one was designed for, but it comes off the other cam. But very ingenious little engine and beautifully made.
Sure is.
Very unusual casting. So probably a one-off.
Here we are outside it. Here goes the shade pulling out.
Yeah.
Here's an urban.
Now I always do mine in the winter time too, and I don't have to move. really talk.
Okay, we'll catch you.
Now we'll go over here and say good morning to Denny.
Hi, Gil. How are you?
I'm well, thanks. Hi, John.
Hi,
nice to see you again.
You too.
Dick Shelley built number four from 1988. Half scale domestic stove pipe. Here's a half scale of a half horse New Holland by K&J Machine. And here's a star. That's a nice hand. This one yours? Yeah, very nice. Morning, Harold.
Morning, morning.
How are you?
Okay, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. Here's a Paul Breeze Olds built by Harold. Here's Harold's domestic. It's one of my favorite little coils right there. Dad made that coil. I love that thing. I think that's great. Uh-huh. That's what I thought that was. Yeah. But he made it into a buzz coil, right? Yeah, it's great. Here's a fawn getting ready to run. Half scale of a 2-horsepower Vaughn. It's a V-bolt kit. These are great runners. Yeah. And here's the Quincy. Another great running man.